Hello friends, this is Durga again from ITVarsity, a one-stop shop to learn all the technologies. At this time we are talking about HDPCD practice exam. Already we have covered 8 tasks. In this video I will be covering the 9th task, which is to perform some tasks on 5 partition tables. So for this they are asking us to create a script or a file with the extension .hive under home Hotom solutions with name weather partition. And in that you should have the script which actually creates the table called weather partitioned, which has the same schema as the SFO underscore weather, but the table has to be partitioned on the year and month columns, and the data is stored in the ORC file format. And also we need to select from SFO underscore weather for year 2008 and for month January and load into weather partitioned. So let's create the file first. I'm copying the file name. And here I have 2 sessions. In the first session, I'm in the solutions directory and I'm actually opening the file. And in the second section, I'm launching Hive. In the second session, I'm launching Hive and we will perform the tasks as they have mentioned. They told that to define a new Hive managed table named weather partition. So copy this table name and start typing the script here. Create table. Table name, open the bracket. And then they're asking us to create the table weather partitioned that has the same schema as SFO underscore weather. For that, as we have launched the Hive, so here run show tables, and there is a table called SFO underscore weather already. So we need to create weather partition with the same structure as SFO underscore weather. So you can say show create table SFO weather and hit enter. In this, we just need to copy the station name and other 4 columns, day of month, precipitation, temperature, max, temperature, min, because year and month are partition tables. So I'm copying station name first and then I'm copying the other 4 fields, and now as the table has to be partitioned, first we need to specify partition by clause, first by year of type int and then month of type int, because the data types of year and month are int in SFO underscore weather. Once you define partition by clause, if they specify to use some custom delimiter, you can say row format delimited, fields terminated by, and give the custom delimiter. But in this case, they haven't emphasized on the delimiter. So we will leave the default delimiter, but they have emphasized that the file has to be, the files under this table has to be of type ORC file. So here we have to say stored as ORC file, which is stored as ORC, and that's it. You don't need to add anything else. Now as the create table command is created, we will test it. The table is created successfully. So save it. And then we have to create the partition. There are multiple ways to do that. If you want, you can do the dynamic partition insert also. But in my case, I'm creating a partition for January 2008 because we have to load for that year and month from SFO underscore weather into weather partition. So here I'm directly adding partition using this syntax, alter table, table name, add partition, year equal to 2008, month equal to 1. Okay, now let us test this alter table command also. And now the partition is also created. Partition and next subpartition for year and month are also created. Now we have to insert the data. Insert into table weather partition. The table name is weather partition. And we have to insert into the partition year 2008 and month one, which is January. So you just copy paste from the add partition syntax, and then here we have to do select all the columns such as station month, sorry, station name, day of month, precipitation, temperature max, and temperature min from SFO underscore weather. This is the source table, where, because we want only for year 2008 and month 1, so where year equal to 2008 and month equal to 1, which means that we are trying to get the data for January 2008 from SFO underscore weather and inserting into table weather partition into one partition and its nested partition for the year 2008 and month 1. So if you see the actual SFO weather and weather partition, even though we have equal number of columns, the order is a little bit different. So you have to specify the column names like this. If you say select star from, it will fail, because in weather partition the second column is day of month, whereas in SFO weather the second column is year. Okay, so you have to select and define the columns explicitly from SFO weather, and then you have to apply this where condition for 2008 and month 1. And also, if you want to add partition prior to running the insert statement, you have to use this command, and then you have to use the partition clause in the insert statement as well. Now you can copy this one and paste it here. Once it is run successfully, we will review the results and also the table structure to see whether our answer is in line with the question they have asked. Okay, now the data is inserted. First, we will preview the data. Select star from weather partition limit 100, and our data looks good. We got data from 2008 January into this partition table, and also you can run describe formatted weather partition to see that our table is managed table, and also we are using ORC file format for this table. And also you can actually do DFS minus LS minus capital R to read the files recursively under weather partition, and you can see that weather partition table have subdirectory year equal to 2008, and that have subdirectory month equal to 1, which have the file. So the data is successfully copied into one of the partition and its subpartition for year 2008 and month equal to January. Okay, so everything looks good. Let's save this file and exit, and let's wrap up. That being said, I hope you are enjoying the content on the channel. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide the feedback, please use the comment section of the video. If you want to discuss further about certifications or big data, please join my LinkedIn group called ITVersity-Certifications or ITVersity-Big Data. And finally, if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will get to see a lot more content like this over time. Thank you. Bye.